have is not as relevant as whose hand you put it in.
Amen.
If you keep it in your hand, you'll be able to eat and have a fish meal. But if you ever get courageous and generous and release the offering to the hands of God, he'll bless it. And what was not enough, all of a sudden, gets blessed. And something is released in the power of an offering. I declare to you this morning that when that mama, can you imagine this little boy, 5 loaves and 2 fish, hanging out with Jesus and the 12 disciples, and his mama packs him a lunch meal and puts 5 loaves and 2 fish in this basket because she looks out the window. I'm just speaking from Wallace's point of view. She looks out the window and says, oh, he's got some friends, the disciples. He's got some friends and they didn't bring no food. So I'm going to give him a few extra loaves and a couple of extras. So put some 5 loaves and 2 fish in a bag and they leave the house that day. That woman, that boy's mama did not know the seed she had given him. And I got a word for mama in here today. You never know the power of the seed you're putting in the hands of your children. And what little bit you're putting in their hands is getting ready to be multiplied because you raise babies and they're going to put it in his hands.
Amen. Amen.
The Bible says that the boy gave the disciples 5 loaves and 2 fish. They brought it to Jesus. Jesus is looking at 20,000 people. They're all having a nervous breakdown. The 12 disciples, can you see them now? How is this going to turn out? And they're halfway bitter because they're getting ready to give their fish meal away. And Jesus said, bring it to me. He blessed it, and then he broke it. And then he puts it back in the hands of people who said it wasn't enough. Because if I ever learned anything about God, it's that God wants you to understand the power of multiplication. He is not just interested in you listening to a testimony of somebody who got a blessing down the road 3 years ago. God wants to take doubting people who do not believe he can multiply, and he wants to put back in your hands what you said was not enough so that as you distribute it, it becomes revelation to you. He says, sit them down in companies of 50. You know what I like about God before he blesses you? He still is a God of decency and order. Y'all better say something here. I said, God is a God of decency and order.
Amen.
God said, I'm going to release blessing, but I still want them to get organized.
Amen.
I'm going to give you a ram caught in the thicket, Abraham, but I need you to lay the wood in order. Oh, y'all better see this thing today. Just because God can doesn't mean it exempts us from not being people of order. He said, you put them in companies of 50 and sit them down. Well, why do we have protocol? Why do we have policy? Why do we? Because this is not some chaotic circus. This is the house of the Lord, and we're going to operate in excellence, and we're going to have protection and safety, and every now and then you just got to have some order. Put them in order. He said, I'm getting ready to take men who said this wasn't enough, and I'm getting ready to put it back into their hands because I want to teach them how to participate in a miracle. When you give 5 loaves and 2 fish, that don't sound like much, but when it's all you've got, it becomes an offering and power is released. So he gives doubting Peter a little basket of food with 5 loaves, with part of the 5 loaves and part of the fish. And Peter's looking at these companies of 50 people sitting there, and 5 loaves and 2 fish ain't enough to feed one of them. So he just starts giving it out. He just starts handing out loaves and fishes. And 20 people into it. He looks down in the box, and there's still more loaves, and there's still more fishes. And 150 people later, he looks down, and there's still more loaves, and there's still more fishes. And Peter's over here hollering at Jane, are you believing this? I give it away, and I don't lose it. You missed it. I let it go, and it just gets replenished. I'm trying to get rid of it, but every time I try to get rid of it, it's still in my basket. I gave to one poor lady, and I thought I lost it, but I checked my other pocket,